If you are going to implement Revit successfully in your project, you will need this video. Because if you want to do that, you need to know the work sharing process and collaboration process in our Revit project, which is one of the most powerful feature of Revit. This is Javadhamidi, co-founder of TATBIM. In this channel, we upload weekly tutorials about Revit, Enscape, Dynamo, and other kind of BIM softwares. So don't forget to like and subscribe us and share this video with your friends and colleagues and ask your questions in the comment section. Collaboration in Revit means if you want to work seamlessly and simultaneously with many, more than one person on one project, you need to share your project with other people with work sharing or collaboration in your Revit project. We have two type of work sharing or collaboration in our Revit project, which one of them is a local network that, for example, you are using a LAN network in your office, or you have a specific server for yourself that your company is working on it. The second way is BIM 360, which is more advanced tools, but you need some additional licenses for that. In this video, I'm going to cover one step of the process for the first time, not the second time, which is how to create central files and how to create local files for our Revit project and how to work with them. Let's go to the screen share and let me show you how to do that.
Yes, as soon as we have created this model so far, and we are going to create by ourselves, and we want to design another building here, but our deadline is so close, or we need some another professions to create on the model at the same time with us. Then we need a work sharing model or central model that will allow many users to work on a model, on the same model, simultaneously. Okay, to do that, you need to go to the collaborate tab, and from here you need to click on collaborate, and then you have two options here. If you're using OneDrive, Dropbox, or your local network, you need to the first option. If you are going to use BIM 360, which is a paid service from Autodesk, you can select the second. But in this video, I'm going to cover this one because I don't have the license for BIM 360, and we don't cover it in this video. You just need to select it and click on OK. And you need to wait a little bit, and your model will be converted to a central model. Immediately after creating a central model, I always save the model. You need to do that. Press Control S, and then you will see a window that will tell you it is the first time that you are saving the model. After you have converted it to a central model, click on yes, and it will be good, and it will be converted completely to central model. Then one tip here: don't work on central files if you are a user. Just BIM managers and owner of the files can work on central files, but just for some operations and maintenance, not for working. For working, you just need to work on local files. But how we can create local files? Let's close this file. I have this file on my desktop, and let's create a local. You just need to click on open, and from the place that you have saved your central file, you just need to select the file, and when these two options are available, you can understand this is a central file. Also, if you have them in your recent files, in new versions of Revit, this box shows you that you have a central file. If you want to work on it as a user and update the central model, update the central model according to your area of work or something else, you need to create a local. But also sometimes if you want to send it to your clients or someone that you don't want them to access to your central file, or you want to create a viewpoint of that time of your project, you need to create a detached file. Okay, let's activate this option and let me create another one. Also for some background processes and optimization, you can check the audit too, that I have mentioned this option in how to optimize your model video in previous videos. You can check it too. Okay, click on open, and now you will have a local file with your username that will attach at the end of the local files. But maybe you are asking how we can update our central models. You just need to create and work with your areas, and each maybe 30 minutes or 20 minutes you can click on this synchronize, and you can update your model according to the central model, and also you will receive the other ones and other users operations. You can see we are synchronizing with this model. You can compress your files from here, and also it is great to relinquish your files to prevent from any disputes. But I will discuss that it works this in depth in future videos. And also you can create a comment. You just need to click on OK. And now we are good to go. And our files have been updated on central model. And also we have received other people's central models. Okay. But let me tell you another tip here. Just relinquish it and we'll talk about the workspace again. But maybe you are trying to open your local, or you want to open your local files, and you don't know where is the directory for them and where is the default directory for them. You just need to go to the file menu, and from here click on option, and from here on file location tab, you have a default files for user files. This is a place that your local files is will be saved on that location, and also you can change it for yourself. But another tip here, when you open the central file again from the desktop, when you open the central file again, you will see a pop-up here that will show you can override the existing copy of your local files that will replace the local files, and don't save another local files there. But I suggest to use append timestamp to existing copy. It will create a copy and also will timestamp the file name, and you will have some backups for your files and your work.
You saw the importance of this process in your project, and if you want to collaborate with more than yourself in your project, and you want to boost your modeling speed and your authoring process, you will need this. I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, please don't forget to like this video and ask your questions in the comments section, and you can help us with sharing this video with your friends and colleagues, and it will help us to create more videos like this. I will see you on the next session.